going to show you how to draw base 10 models. Students learn to draw models to demonstrate their understanding of place value. In the student toolkit, students have a flat representing 100, a rod representing 10, and a unit representing 1. When we're drawing models of numbers, we start with an HTO chart. Your chart needs to have 3 columns, and you want to make sure there's enough room to model the number. We start with an H for the hundreds place, a T for the tens place, and an O for the ones place. When we're modeling our numbers, we show a flat by using a square, we show a rod by using a line, and we show a unit by using a small circle. We're going to practice modeling a few different numbers. The first number we're going to practice modeling is the number 54. In the number 54, we have 5 tens and 4 ones. We're going to start in our ones place and we're going to draw 4 ones. Now we're going to move to our tens place and we're going to draw our 5 tens. It's important to make sure that the model is nice and neat so we can count clearly. Now let's count and make sure we have the right number. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54. Let's try a harder number. We're going to start with an empty HTO chart. This time, we're going to model the number 380. Now, in the number 380, we don't have any ones, so we're going to leave our ones column blank. We're going to move to our tens. We have 8 tens. And then we have 3 hundreds. Now it's important to count our number to make sure that our model matches our number. 100, 200, 300, 310, 320, 330, 340, 350, 360, 370, 380. You can model any number within 1,000.